What is going on? We are here at Muscle HQ. Is it Muscle Hut HQ or Muscle HQ?
Muscle HQ.
Muscle HQ. I was calling it Muscle Hut in the car, so to scrap that. Muscle HQ. Tyler's place. Tyler, you good?
Good, thank you.
All
good.
How many weeks since prep now?
We're about 7 weeks in.
7 weeks.
About 12 to go. Yeah.
So what you got, trip in a week and a bit.
Yep.
He's got a little break gap in prep with a little trip, obviously continuing prep in there, and then it'll be the final push into the start of the season now. So we'll run some visuals after we train, but also a really good we were talking a minute ago, a really good topic of conversation on bodyweight set points and look relative to what's been here and what's been in the past. And for Ty, I think it's the relevance of trying to detach away from the value of scale weight relative to just where the look is itself.
Yeah,
because if you just saw that 107 on the scale, you'd be like, I need to be 105 or 104 now.
Yeah.
I need to be ahead.
Yeah.
Whereas if you detach the scale weight and just look at the look, it's like, oh, this is actually representing a much sharper package than what that scale weight's telling me.
Yeah.
Whether that's just the start up for prep, you've come from a higher set point, or there's just more tissue there as well. There'd be a couple of reasons there, but it's an interesting conversation. So we've got back today, an area that you've been nailing in this off season, and as you can see, it's probably bought half of his gym to match that. We've got pull downs, rows, all sorts of stuff. But he's basically got some hand-picked kit for him, just to get the job done a little bit more effectively in terms of exercise selection, especially for the length of your levers and what you had to improve in terms of back development.
Yeah.
He's got great delts, great chest, great arms, but that posterior chain was an element, particularly the mid-back as well, was an element that needed to match the front shots, which is a really well balanced now. So we'll talk you through the movement patterns, we'll talk you through the session, and we'll take it from there. What's loading wise, what do you normally do on here? Work up to like four plates or so?
I'd go five plates top set.
Top set for five?
Yeah. Yeah, going back to that that initial set point of what weight is, it was like just before you came in, there was a guy, and you know, people say it to you all the time. They would say, well, how come, you know, why do you need a coach? You know what you're doing. And I said, yeah, but you'll get two different types of people. You get people who will be a lot harder on themselves, or you'll get people who will just take it way too easy. Oh, I'm a bit tired, I need a refeed and all that sort of stuff. I says, and if I was coaching myself at the minute, I'd have woken up this morning and I'd be like, right, hours cardio.
Yeah, another 200 calories cardio.
Yeah, let's take 50 grams of carbs off, you know. And
I think the biggest thing there is also, especially, well, to be fair, it's the same as an amateur trying to get a pro car, but it's especially different for a pro trying to qualify for the Olympia. So you budget those shows that you're going to do across the season.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, the goal is to always win the first show. And it's like, right, I'm boxed off. I've got my ticket into the O. But you've also got to be, strategic in terms of like, right, if I get second or third here, what's my next move?
Yeah.
And if you go hell to leather for that first show, and you've misplaced potentially the second or the third option, say, for example, last year when you said there's an 8-week gap.
Yeah.
That then has a compromise for the entire season.
Yeah.
And then it's like that then carries over to the Olympia itself as well. Because if you're peeled at 4 weeks out from the first show, you go to the first show, you're split center, they go with the other chap, and you're second.
Yeah.
Right, next show in 4 weeks' time.
Yeah.
You've been peeled for 8 weeks now.
Yeah.
And every week that goes past, it's a little bit harder to hold.
Yeah, of course it is. And you start fading, you're not quite as full. Then you start chasing the fullness, but the fullness doesn't come, it just blurs off.
Yeah. It's like you almost lose the middle ground between them both.
Yeah.
So the timing element's a massive thing there. Massive thing. And, you know, people that coach themselves, it's fucking massive respect for, because it's a massive psychological game. But
oh, big time.
Just having the ability to not make emotionally driven decisions there is one of the biggest things.
Yeah.
Because like you said, for you, it's like, you know, you can work hard. So it's like, fuck it.
Yeah,
right.
That's it.
And drop this meal out.
Yeah.
Add that cardio.
Yeah. And that's why I could never do it myself.
Yeah.
That's it, mate. straight down in the hole. There you go. Go on. Come on.
It's nice that. Holding that as well is a little bit more comfortable, whereas the one that Shreds has got, you can't really brace on anything.
Oh, okay.
Makes it a little bit more difficult. Nice. Good. On for that. Good. Yeah. Good. Good. Whip that. There you go. Nice. Good.
Yep, let's work.
One.
Yep, let's go. Got it, mate.
That's nice. So Ty was doing, well, for this off-season phase, two main back sessions. You were tagging on a little bit of upper back for one of the other sessions as well. So it was technically three lots of back across the week, but one of them was tag on for his upper back, which is the main area. And then two of them were two main pull-based sessions. But like today will be an example of where he does lat first, where he's working both lengthened and short arm ranges, so like both extremities. And then the last two exercises will be more mid-back. So he's getting a complete challenge for both sides there. Nice. Stay locked in there. One more.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah, normally just.
Once if you're accurate on there, like my lat's fucking full up now.
Yeah, they're just like primed ready to
it's
go now.
On.
Yeah.
Yeah, the only bit of kit I'd say is potentially just a fixed chest support T-bar.
Yeah.
That's really all it is.
Which, to be honest, with the footprint of them, I could get one in quite easy.
Yeah, they're only small.
They're only thin, yeah.
They're only small.
It, mate. Yep, squeeze in. There you go. Get it in there. Go on. That's it. That's where we want to be. In there. There you go. And again. Go on. Go on.
Oh, yeah. That's nice.
That's it, mate. Stretch, and then all the way in. There you go. That's the one. Yep, come on.
One more?
Yep, let's go. Hold on, mate.
That was nice. So both the gym shop bits of kit will drop off quite a lot in that shorter position for the lap. So it's gonna get lighter where you're weaker, in essence. And you could make the argument that you wanna, or you could, put pieces like this at the end of a session where you're gonna be tired in that shortened range where you're weaker, and then it's gonna be a little bit more accommodating having that load lighter in that position. But what we've done for T over this last off-season phase is he's relearned a lot of the stuff for his lats, and it's an area that he needed to focus on, getting especially that lower lat, because his lats are big, but it's just a little bit more refinement through his development, lower lat and mid-back. And bits of kit like this, where it's lighter, where you'd normally have a little bit more of a difficult time contracting there or controlling, has really allowed him to spend time there, hold the contractions for a little bit longer, hold the stretch position for a little bit longer, not rush the concentric phase of the rep as quickly potentially as he would have done before. And as a result of that, he's able to create harder reps. And as a result of creating harder reps, he's creating better reps. And you see a lot of guys like this, he's already an IFBB pro. You know, he's had years and years and years of success as an athlete. He used to be a super heavyweight bodybuilder. He's got a lot of muscle. So you'd see that for face value, you'd be like, these guys don't need to learn how to train again. But everyone's got imperfections in the look, and everyone's got areas of underdevelopment, poor development relative to other areas of their physique that will need addressing. And the only way you can address those things is by stripping things back. So if you just continue to do what you've always done, 9 times out of 10, it's gonna lead to the same outcome over and over again. And the areas that he's stronger in, like his chest, his delts, his arms, will get stronger. And the areas that you needed to improve on and why you was potentially not being rewarded on stage are gonna get poorer, because those areas are gonna overshine them. So for him, it was just a case of stripping it back and relearning movement patterns, spending more time in those reps, and getting better at contracting those muscles as well. There you go. Elbow down. Nice. Yeah. Good, T. Good. Yeah, nice. Good.
Come on. There you go. That's it. In the hole. There you go.
Yeah, that's about right at the moment. There's room to push that, but again,
I think it's just sort of like taking it to failure enough, and then it's just sort of pushing those three reps in, just into the hole, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, straight on the lap. Come on. Good. Yeah, there's more.
Two more.
Yeah. Again, one more. Good lad. Nice. Good. Been taking two or three there?
Two. Yeah, just two.
Let's go, we'll go two upper back row, and then we'll do three upper back pull down.
Okay.
On that D handle. Yeah.
Yeah.
One more. 10.
Do try 10, because the jump is quite
severe.
Yeah.
Let's do 10. Let's try and get on here. Let's try and get that protraction over the pad.
Okay.
To lean into it and then retract back against
it.
Yeah,
right, okay.
So you get a little bit more through that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Upper back. Yeah, I'll work here.
Yeah, that's it. Go on, mate. Go
That's good for load, and we'll go down from there.
Okay.
Nice, there you go. Let's go, good 6 to 8. Nice. It's 1 second in the squeeze at the back. There you go. Drive. Good, Ty. Drive. Good. I'll give you a little bit in that M range. Hold the squeeze there. Yeah, keep those elbows a little bit higher. There you go. That's it. Control. Yeah, couple more. One more. One more. Yeah, good.
So we've just done up on that row where the elbows, the intent with the line piece high, but elbows are pulling out, and now we're going to take it from that overhead position, pretty much the exact same thing where Ty's the single out his elbows, pulling away from the spine, so we're taking that slightly wider angle for the upper back now.
Just realised the microphone's at the front, I've got it on backwards. But yeah, 2 sets here to finish that line of pull for the upper back, and then we'll do a little bit of rear delts. Ty doesn't get to do biceps because he's too big. Nice, mate. Good.
Go on, Cal. Go on. Oof. Squeeze.
Oh, 2.
Yep.
Oh, 1.
Yep. Oh, good leg.
Let's go. Nicely.
Let's go, a couple more.
Again, one more. Yeah, nice.
Because for years I've only trained back once a week.
Yeah. So
yeah.
You got hinge there. You've got way more overhead pulling. You've got way more horizontal pulling.
Yeah.
And all that, you're getting a little bit of stimulus there every single time.
Yeah.
It's like if you were doing if you suddenly doubled your pressing volume, you'd be like, oh, triceps
would be
responded.
Yeah. Oh. That's it, go on. Yep. Yep.
2.
Yep, let's go. Yep, and again.
1 more. Oh, yeah.
Well done, mate.
Go rears?
Yeah.
Go rears and I'll take you to the posing?
Yeah. Go on. Yeah, so some little ones. There you go. Well done, mate.
The bar path's nice, isn't it?
The what?
The path that it moves
in. Oh, okay, nice. Yeah.
You just got to get out of that first rep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. Good. Come on. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Nice.
Come on, mate. Yep. Let's get what we can now. Yep. All on the rears. There you go.
Yeah. Do three here total?
Three.
Three more. Let's go. Good. Nice. Yeah. Couple more. Good. Fast and finish. Five. One. Two. Three. Four. Difference that makes with everything through here as well, yeah. Even your chest as well, just looks so much more prominent. Nice. Nice. Yeah, that back is so improved, bud. Now that lower back's starting to pull through.
Yeah.
In terms of like this, because your waist has come in as well. Yeah. Good. Transition back. Yeah, it's a fucking dominant front pose that. There, yeah. You can see, those two machines we did at the start as well?
Yeah.
When you're digging into that lower lat with the lower elbow pull, even on your back now, when you contract, if you contract your rear shot there, even just down to those disattachments on your lat there, you can just see that new tissue just sitting there.
Once you pull this off.
That's what I mean, it's literally gonna be, your lat's just gonna go literally from the base of your erector all the way down to your hip.
Yeah.
Whereas remember when I said before about your lat's almost, your lats were big, but it was almost like they felt like they sat high in the pose.
Yeah.
It's just that extra recruitment now. Your lats are all the way down to your hip. Makes that rear shot gnarly, mate. Looks nuts. Nuts. When you hit that rear shot when you've come down, yeah. If you're going to reset it,
yeah.
Maybe just pull back just to show a little bit more mid-back.
Okay.
And then push back into the lats just so you can see a little bit of both. Because you've got that detail now as well.
Into
yeah, and then wide, and then if they say like if they go right, fucking everyone shuffle to the left, and you have to reset your pose.
Yeah,
you can
go
straight back in. You can pull it. You can rank it back, and then pull back out wide.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And now we've got hit that pose again. Now we've got more of that mid trap. Got more rhomboid. You've got more erector. You've got more. Lower trap there, rear delts are bigger, and then lats are sitting lower as well.
Yeah.
And you can even see, to be fair, just those the hip hinges that you've done, just more tissue through your erectors as well.
Yeah.
It's notable from that rear shot, very notable.
Yeah.
And then the crucial thing here will be, because you can hit that conditioning, you say we get to 4 weeks out and it's like we're pretty much bang on the button now in terms of lower back conditioning, your abs are in, obliques are in. You're then in a position where you're potentially in the last preps, you're in a position where you were trying to hold onto that conditioning set point, and those areas that potentially didn't hold as much muscle were then the first ones to fade. And the strong ones stayed strong, but then some faded.
Yeah.
We're in a position there where you can just feed as needed to hold that fullness.
Yeah.
So it's like, right, a couple of days a week, we spike your calories up around those pull sessions across the week. You maximize fullness on those days and then trickle down on the others. And you can then hold that look for a longer period of time. Onto stage. I'm glad I saw you instead of just going off those photos.
That's why you do a checking video, you watch it back yourself, and you think, I think I look better.
Yeah, exactly.
That's funny.
There you go. So you used to be a fucking super heavyweight, you know? Same class as Josh. What year was that you last competed then?
2015.
NABBA?
Yeah.
Did you do UK BFF as well?
Yeah. Yeah, I've competed against
Mullington. Oh, I know. Yeah, I've seen photos of. I've seen photos of the UK BF, UK BABF ones. Well,
yeah, I've competed against.
So that is pull, lats, mid back bit, rear delts done.
Two lat, two mid back, and one rear delt. The improvements are very, very evident.
I feel it. Yeah, I can feel it. Yeah.
Well, I think, like you said just then in the video, it was those two, the upper pec, which I think for you in this off-season phase has just been training the upper pec consciously more.
Yeah.
And then just the frequency on your back as well.
Yeah.
Because before you know we transitioned in, it was typical kind of bro split.
Yeah.
Everything heavy, hard. Once a week.
But obviously
frequency is going to lead to same development patterns, and you train something more frequently with better execution, it's going to respond.
Yeah, keeping that volume in there has made a massive difference.
Yep. Yeah, frequency and added volume. So very, very happy with that this far out. 107 kilos now, with darting between 106, 107. This is good. Obviously, I didn't see you in that last prep at this body weight set point, because obviously I know you said you would expect to be a little bit lighter now, but body composition here with the time that you've got left is very, very good. So it's one thing to understand with like new muscle that's been built, especially for his back now, you don't want to be in a position where you've built that new tissue and it's not stayed there for a long period of time and then you're just pulling body weight down harsh.
Yeah.
Because 9 times out of 10, it's almost like that new added force just starts to wash away the more aggressive
you
the
losses. You just diet it away.
You just bully it off. So I think for you now you've had this more consistent trend of body weight. You're getting sharper, yes, but that tissue staying on, that body weight's retaining. It's going to show in that end product. So very, very excited. I'm sure we'll get another one in at some point in the next several weeks leading into that first show. That is a wrap. Thanks for having us.
Bring it on. Cheers, mate.